So now I can also do what's called a whip stitch, which is another very basic stitch. And I can show you how I do that. We're gonna go ahead and have the knot just because I don't want to waste the thread, because I don't have a loop at the end to do the knotless beginning. So again, I'm gonna pinch it, I'm gonna wrap it, I'm gonna smush it, and then scrape it down. And so I have this knot. Yeah, it's barely there, it's right there. So for the whip stitch, you're just gonna whip around and around and around. So you come up, you always wanna come up from the back side first. That puts all of the quote unquote ugliness on the back side. And then with a basic whip stitch, you go at an angle. There are no specific rules as to what kind of an angle. The closer your stitches are together, the more perpendicular it's going to be. If you have them far apart, you're going to have a much more soft angle like that. But again, that's going to be more thread to get caught on things. So what I do, and again, like the running stitch, you don't necessarily need to go all the way down and then come all the way up. I find I have more control when I just go in a little bit and then I come up. So I have a section of the bottom fabric and then just that little bit of the top fabric. And then I go in a little bit and then I come back up. So you just go around and around like that. And this, if you're using like an embroidery floss, it can make a nice little decorative edging. If this were an actual patch, then the edges are going to fray, and that can be a design feature that you like this flannel underneath here. I didn't do any treatment to the edge before I washed it, so I've got this nice fuzzy, soft feeling edge, and some people like that. And so I just go around and around. And then when it's time to end, we're almost there. So periodically, you should stop and make sure that the threads are doing what you want them to do so you don't end up with that big pucker like I had at the other one. So we're going to end this. We're going to go down like we've always been doing, but we're not going to come back up again. So we're just going to come all the way through the back side. And then again, we're going to take a little bit. I will show you a quilter's knot, where what you do is you take your thread that you were using and you wrap it around the needle twice. And I wrap it around over and you kind of gently hold it there with your forefinger and you pull through the fabric and those extra loops. I don't think I can, I haven't found that I'm able to get it as tight with this knot as I am with the other. I usually end up with little things like this hanging off, so I don't enjoy it as much, but if it works for you, then go for it. That it still creates a knot. It's still not going to pull out. So see, I'm pulling on that. It's totally fine. And then you cut it off, and there you go.